So, we've all been there. You ran your mouth off around the wrong people, and now they're trying to gun you down. Of course, normally you just whip out your own sidearm and smoke the mother flippers. But this time, you've only gone and left your trusty pistol at home. Nightmare. As you run for your life with deadly assailants hot on your tail, and who hasn't, you conveniently pass by a large body of water. And remember all the TV shows and films which show heroes avoiding a hail of bullets by simply diving underwater. But exactly how realistic is this?
I'm Stu, this is Debunked, and we're here to sort the truths from the myths and the facts from the misconceptions. This video is sponsored by Fabulous.
As you can imagine, firearms are a diverse group of weapons that work differently depending on the type, design, and ammunition, etc. But in general, most guns do not play well with water. Firing into water from above the surface is far less effective and significantly less lethal than your usual land-based gun shenanigans. This is because most guns are designed to propel bullets through the air. And while air resistance obviously has an effect on how fast and far a bullet can travel, it certainly hasn't stopped us from pumping each other full of lead for hundreds of years. Water, on the other hand, provides substantially more resistance. As a bullet travels through water, it collides with an unfathomable number of water molecules. Each individual collision causes a minuscule amount of energy to be transferred from the bullet to the molecule. This continues until the bullet is depleted of energy and the bullet comes to a stop. Due to the density of water, this energy transfer occurs at a rate significantly faster than when the bullet pushes through molecules in our air, meaning it has less energy to push through your body. For comparison, regular garden variety air only weighs around 1.25 kilograms per cubic meter, meaning it is fairly easy to fire bullets through the atmosphere with deadly force. Whereas water weighs roughly 1,000 kilograms per cubic meter, making it somewhere in the region of 800 times denser than air. Obviously, this dramatically changes the lethality of firearms built to operate at standard atmospheric pressure. The speed a bullet can travel through water and the distance it is able to travel is highly dependent on its angle of entry.
Now, the speed a bullet can travel through water and the distance it is able to travel is highly dependent on the angle of entry.
Studies have shown that standard projectiles fired at angles of 5 to 15 degrees from the water's surface are unlikely to even enter the water, as they tend to ricochet off from the surface or break up into pieces upon impact. One study conducted in 2008 at the King Abdullah University of Science and Technology found that
most standard bullets appear to enter successfully only when fired above 11 degrees.
So if your bad guys are firing at you from a particularly shallow angle, they aren't going to pose much of a threat to you at all. Bad news for your would-be killers. While bad guys with pistols might not be out to get me on a daily basis, what is often hiding around the corner are bad habits, which knock me off course and put me behind with deadlines and generally lead to stress and anxiety.
But recently, I've been using a great little tool called Fabulous to help introduce good habits into my daily routine.
It was developed at Duke University and uses behavioral science to build healthy habits into your life that guide you to goals that you want to achieve. These habits start with simple steps that lead to bigger leaps towards improving your well-being. I have a few carefully selected reminders throughout my day. These are as simple as remembering to eat a good breakfast to more comprehensive goals like listing the three most important tasks that I want to achieve each day. Today's would be avoiding as much lethal lead as I can. In less than 5 minutes, Fabulous can set up a custom program for you that will cater towards whatever challenges you're currently facing. Whether you're overwhelmed with anxiety and want a healthier lifestyle, or want to improve your productivity and structure your day, this fabulous little tool can get you on your way to where you want to be.
You can build your ideal daily routine by clicking on my link in the description. The first 500 of you click on the link will get 25% off on Fabulous Premium.
Let's return to today's important task, surviving bullets underwater. Now you've got enemies coming at you from all angles, and they've got some pretty serious hardware pointing right at you. How deep are you going to need to dive to dodge their lethal lead? Well, the surprising factor that you have on your side is that the more serious the hardware, the less threat they may pose to you while you're underwater. Believe it or not, the bigger the caliber bullet and the faster the muzzle velocity, the shorter the distance it will travel after entry into the water. The brainiacs over at MythBusters came across this phenomenon while investigating this particular quandary. They fired a 223 caliber bullet, which leaves the barrel at a supersonic 2,500 feet per second, or 2,700 kilometers per hour. They followed this with a whopping 50 caliber bullet, which travels at a staggering 3,000 feet per second, or around 3,300 kilometers per hour. When these bullets hit the water's surface, both bullets essentially exploded into pieces, and their lethality would have been totally eliminated again within 2 to 3 feet, or just under a meter of water. Incredibly, you're actually in a lot more danger if your pursuers are carrying handguns. A 9mm bullet travels at a comparatively slow, but still pretty rapid, 1,300 feet per second, or just over 1,400 kilometers per hour. So, what makes this the more deadly bullet? Well, when an object enters the water, it encounters resistance. And the faster the object is traveling, the greater the resistance it will experience as it enters this new state of matter. This resistance causes the object to decelerate. In our case, we have lower velocity bullets, like a 9mm, travelling at a respectable 1,300 feet per second, or 1,400 kilometers per hour. The deceleration it experiences occurs over a couple of meters. Over this distance, it is depleted of energy. It slows to a stop and then sinks to the bottom. When higher velocity bullets enter the water, on the other hand, they experience substantially more resistance. Whilst a slower bullet can displace the water in front of it relatively easily, at the staggering velocity of a 50 caliber bullet, there simply isn't enough time to move the water out of the way. The massive resistance this exerts on the bullet can exceed the bullet material strength, causing it to deform or disintegrate into multiple pieces as it enters the water. The huge resistance and loss of energy required to tear the material apart means that in certain circumstances, a faster bullet can end up traveling less far than its less speedy counterpart. So, when a puny 9mm bullet is fired into water from a vertical angle, it could mean the end for you, unless you dive relatively deep, because one of these will be lethal to a depth of 7 foot, or just over 2 meters below the surface. Meaning, you'd need to get down to 8 feet or lower to ensure you didn't even sustain a flesh wound. But hang on, if it's the impact with the water surface that's causing the bullet to initially decelerate so much and lose the majority of its energy, why doesn't your trigger-happy pursuer hop into the water with you and shoot at you while you're fully submerged? Oh, sorry.
But don't worry too much, because for a technology that already doesn't mix well with water, dunking your average firearm into good old H2O is not a good idea.
Even though some firearms, like Glocks, can generally be relied upon to fire underwater, this is not true for most guns. And even when they do discharge fully submerged, the results are often far less than adequate. As soon as you dip a gun under the surface, water almost immediately fills up all the various nooks and crannies it can reach. First and foremost, water can soak into the cartridges themselves, making the propellant too wet to ignite, preventing the gun from firing at all.
That being said, modern cartridges are often watertight. However, even if the firing pin has managed to ignite the gunpowder grains, the bullet's problems don't stop there.
When a barrel is fired underwater rather than into water, the increased resistance of squillions of water molecules are acting upon the bullet from the moment it is fired. This means that the bullet will have to push against all this water, which may weigh considerably more than the bullet itself, before it even exits the barrel. So naturally, the bullet's muzzle velocity, i.e. the speed at which the bullet is traveling the moment it exits the gun barrel or muzzle, is drastically reduced.
But how far away would you need to be to dodge this amphibious lead?
Well, once again, some televised lunatic has actually tested this. In 2015, Norwegian physicist Andreas Wahl decided to investigate this exact situation on a Norwegian television show called Life on the Line, in which he demonstrates scientific principles in a variety of seemingly dangerous ways. Standing in a pool, with all but his head underwater, Wahl positioned himself directly in the line of fire of a submerged firearm. This time an AG-3 assault rifle, which, on land, has a muzzle velocity of 2,625 feet per second. That's over 2,800 kilometers per hour. And has an effective firing range of around 1,300 feet, or 400 meters. When the gun fired, the bullet traveled less than a meter, before slowing down almost entirely, then sinking harmlessly to the bottom of the pool.
So, in each scenario, you'll only have to be a few feet away from your assailant to avoid being hit. Still, your would-be killer may yet have a very slight chance of success in the highly unlikely event that they have a very specific type of weapon to hand.
These weapons often differ from conventional guns in a number of ways. Firstly, they often don't fire regular bullets, but dart-like metal bolts, which move through the water far more easily than their bulky, rounded counterparts. Some of these weapons also utilize pressurized gas instead of combustible propellants, avoiding the usual issues with submerging cartridges in water. Underwater firearms are also frequently made without helical grooves or rifling on the inside of the barrel, as the bolts instead rely on the hydrodynamics of water to maintain a steady path on the way to their target, meaning weapons like the Soviet APS underwater rifle aren't technically rifles. As a result, underwater firearms can have an effective range of up to 30 meters, or almost 100 feet, at shallow depths, though this is significantly lessened the deeper you go.
Still, better than only a few feet.
If your enemy happens to possess one of these guns, jumping into the water will provide you with far less protection than with regular firearms. In addition, there is the possibility of using supercavitating rounds that are specially designed to penetrate deeper into water than your standard run-of-the-mill bullets. They are made with flat tips that push the water around its sharp edges extremely quickly, causing a drop in pressure that creates a gaseous cavity around itself. This drastically reduces the bullet's contact with the water, preventing skin friction drag and thereby allowing it to slice through the water much faster and further than conventional bullets. Instead of stopping or even breaking apart after a few feet, supercavitating bullets can be accurately fired as far as 60 meters, or just under 200 feet, into water, rendering your once ingenious aquatic defenses effectively useless. Ultimately, however, it's clear that diving sufficiently deep underwater can protect you from all but the most specialized weaponry. Still, probably best not to trigger people with guns in the first place. Okay, guys? Thanks for watching, thank you to our Patreons, and we'll see you next time.